Welcome. In the name of Jesus Christ, the love of God made flesh, I greet you and I welcome you to this service of worship. We gather in our respective homes, but we are one through the love and grace of Christ. At this time, I would draw your attention to the life and work of our church, which is found printed in our order of service and the announcements. For those who aren't familiar with where the bulletin is located at the very top of our website where it says weekly announcements in plain text, and it's located on the left hand of the screen down in PDF form with the date for today's service. In terms of announcements, just drawing your attention to a couple of the things. The first is that during the provincial lockdown, the church office is going to be closed, but we are still checking the voicemails, the emails, and of course the mail slot. So if you do need to contact us, please do reach out. Our congratulations and best wishes to all who received diplomas or degrees at the spring convocation at St. Effects on Friday night. May God bless you in your future plans. We are getting closer to high school graduation time as well. So the St. James UCW and Men's Club have their bursary, which is available for graduates from high school. There is information in your bulletin, and I certainly would draw your attention to that and to the deadline, which is fast approaching. As well, we still do have our lockdown Great Litter Challenge for those who are interested. More information in our order of service. Let's take a moment and prepare ourselves for worship. Let's join together in our call to worship. The love God has for us and the love we are to have for each other can bear all things, face all things, and endure all things. For such love is patient and kind. It is not envious or boastful or rude. It does not insist on its own way, but is humble and considerate. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. And such love never ends. Let us pray together. Eternal God, we are your people because you choose us to be your people. In love you created us, in love you save us, and in love you offer us the promise of eternal life. Surround us with your love, we pray. Hold us in our uncertainty and speak to us once again of your grace and mercy, which is ours through Jesus Christ. Amen. There was an online class about this time of year for school-aged children. And the teacher had a few more moments left and figured she would just ask the kids, what are the three most precious words to hear? And she knew with Mother's Day coming up what most of the children would choose. And indeed, our class all responded, I love you are the three best words that you can say. Except there was one child who didn't. And curious, the teacher asked him, she said, why didn't you say that I love you were the three best words? And he said, because they're not. How can they not be? She asked, as echoed all of the classmates. And the boy said, well, I love you are words that anyone can say, and sometimes you mean them and sometimes you don't. But when you say, I choose you, you're showing that you do love. And you're not just saying those words. You're opening up your life to show how that love is going to touch the life of the other person. The teacher and the classmates didn't say anything, and then they all agreed. Buried in our gospel lesson today, Jesus says, I chose you. And the words we may not even pay much attention to as we're listening to everything else that's in the lesson, but they're very important words. Because we've all heard that God loves us, but those three little words, I chose you, means that God does love us and that God has made space for us. Space for us in the kingdom of heaven and space for us in all that God is doing through Jesus. Let's join our hearts together and pray as Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let's join together in our responsive psalm. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will I look for help? My help comes from God who has made heaven and earth. God will not let your foot stumble. The one who protects Israel will not slumber. The one who protects you will neither slumber nor sleep.
The help is in the name of our God.
It is God who protects you, your defense at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. God will protect you from all evil. God will protect your life. God will protect your going and coming, now and forever.
Our help is in the name of our God.
Our first lesson this morning, or today, is coming from the Acts of the Apostles, reading in the 10th chapter. While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles. For they heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" So he ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for several days. And from the first letter of John, continuing to read in the 5th chapter. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ has been born of God. And everyone who loves the parent loves the child. By this we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we obey his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whatever is born of God conquers the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world, our faith. Who is it that conquers the world? But the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. And the Gospel of Jesus according to John. Jesus said, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another. May Almighty God bless to us a further understanding of these words, and to the name of God be eternal glory and honor and praise. Amen. There were times when I was a child that I got scared during the night. Sometimes I had a bad dream, sometimes I felt sick, and sometimes I woke up and worried that I was all alone in the house. No matter how late at night, or indeed early in the morning it was, I would go into my parents' room because I knew someone who loved me would be there to reassure me, to help me, and to remind me that things would be okay. This week's gospel lesson is a continuation of the discussion from last week about abiding, which Jesus has with the disciples in the upper room as he prepares them for the crucifixion and the resurrection. The verses today are a reminder that when we abide, when we draw close and stay with Jesus, that we are surrounded with love. Because God's love for us is seen in Jesus, and there's no greater love possible. So when we're anxious, when we're unsure, when life is difficult, we know we can turn to Jesus and find reassurance, help, and the strength we need to get through the day. And I know that for many of you, that's a familiar message because we've all heard of God's love for us. Most of us grew up singing, "Jesus loves me." And indeed, the message of God's love runs through all the pages of Scripture. Yet the truth is that when we're living in times like this, when the world is in chaos, when we're afraid and anxious, we sometimes doubt there is any help, and we don't know what to do or where to turn. Which is why all of us need to be reminded that when we turn to Jesus, we experience the surprising, invigorating, and endless love of God for our lives. And know that even if your life has been less than perfect, that God's love is still there for you. And understand that even if you struggled in your faith, that God's love is still there for you. And trust that even if you've never felt it before, that God's love is still there for you. Because before we chose to come to Jesus, and even if we're still not sure about Jesus, Jesus chose to come to us. Chose us to offer us the grace, the forgiveness, the peace, and the hope of God for our lives. Not because we've done enough good deeds or because we've gone to church, or because we've said the right words or prayed the right prayer, or indeed for any other thing we have said or done. No, we are chosen by Jesus because God loves us. And in his life, Jesus teaches us of that love, shows us that love, and demonstrates on the cross that nothing, not even death itself, can stop that love from reaching for us, holding on to us, and from being part of our lives. And let me be clear, you are chosen by God to be part of the kingdom of heaven now and in the life to come. You are precious, important, and blessed by God. You are loved. And I know that when the storms of life, and especially for some, the storm of this third wave of COVID, when those storms are raging, it's hard to feel the truth of those words. When you feel alone, when you're afraid, when the certainties of life that you've come to rely on are gone, then it doesn't feel like you're precious or important or blessed or even loved. Which is why I say, turn to Jesus. Turn to Jesus with your fears, your uncertainty, your pain. Pray about what's bothering you. Read the good news and hear again of how God will never abandon you or forsake you. Experience the embrace of the Holy Spirit and know that you're not alone and that you are loved. Because I have no doubt that the love which created us, which went to the cross and suffered to save us, which rose from the grave and spread out in the lives of believers at Pentecost, I have no doubt that love is here for you this day, for I know, I believe, I am certain, because I am a witness to the fact that nothing can stop the love of God. So turn to Jesus. Know that there is comfort, there is hope, there is peace. Know that even while we're separated from each other, in faith we are still together. Know that this day you are loved by God. Know the promises of Jesus for your life and for our world. Discover the power and promise of that love for you. Discover the peace and the hope which can be part of your life. Discover the possibilities and potentials which love opens up even at times like this. Because there is no greater love than the love we see expressed in Jesus Christ. And no greater life than one which draws strength, hope, and direction from that love. And no greater day than the one where we experience and trust and live in that love. And as we take comfort in that message, as we experience a new day dawning because of God's love, we hear the other part of the lesson, that we are to love one another as God loves us. And again, I know that's a message that you've heard before. You know Jesus calls us to love one another, and that instruction also runs through the pages of the Bible. As Christians, we are to share and to show the love of Jesus through our words and our actions. We are to love each other as Jesus loves us. And I also know that love looks a bit different this year. After all, we're locked down and we can't gather with friends, family, and neighbors. We'd like to be at the Arisaig lobster dinner, gathered around a restaurant table or a kitchen table with loved ones, or even traveling to see a mother or a grandmother. But this year, there is no Mother's Day family dinner, no traveling, no tables of friends in restaurants. But make no mistake about it, that's actually a sign of our love for each other, because we're doing what we need to do to keep each other safe. We're canceling gatherings, staying in our communities, keeping to our households. And none of that prevents us from sending cards, from sending presents, from making phone calls and video calls, and from reaching out to express and to share our loves. Because COVID hasn't stopped us from being able to love, but it's forcing us to find new ways to show our love and to care for one another. As a Christian family, we would usually gather in this building on this day to celebrate God's love. And today, we're gathering in our own homes, praising and still being the church. On Mother's Day, we would be grateful for our mothers and all the women who have enriched our lives. And today, there's nothing stopping us from doing that. As followers of Jesus, we hear the call to love one another as Jesus loves us. And today, we pray for each other. We connect with each other, and we're finding those new ways to care for and show the love of God to each other. I know the times are unnerving, and that the news this past week has been discouraging, and we may be in a lockdown for a while longer. But that doesn't change the fact that God loves us and calls us to abide in Jesus and to know that love in our lives. And none of that changes the fact that we are commanded to love one another as Jesus loves us. And honestly, when we know God's love and when we share that love, we help make this confusing and uncertain world better, both for ourselves and for the people around us. Let's gather our hearts together. Let us pray. Loving God, we often pray for each other, and so we should, but we know it's also important for us to pray for ourselves. In many ways, we're struggling and stumbling in our lives, and we need your assistance to live successfully. Help us, we ask, in our personal relationships, We try to get along with our spouses, our parents, our children and brothers and sisters, our co-workers, our neighbors, and even other members of the church. But it's not always easy. Understandably, we sometimes have differences of opinion on such things as politics and faith, and all of us face stresses because of the restrictions. But then we allow our legitimate differences and our anxieties and fears to spill over into personal animosities. Help us to acknowledge the need for patience and forgiveness in our lives, and share with us the grace to forgive others, to be patient with them, and to ask for their patience and forgiveness. Help us to know the difference between the things that are minor and those that are truly significant. May we understand that we are called not only to keep going during these times, but to actively work to make this world a better place. Eternal God, we pray for each other this day, remembering with gratitude the mothers, grandmothers, and women in our lives who have been an example and a witness to your love. Let us not only appreciate those who have touched our lives, but help us to share what we have been given with others. We pray for our neighbors, our families, our friends, remembering those who are in hospital, those who are struggling with the isolation, and those who are facing illnesses in their lives, be they physical, mental, spiritual, or some combination of all of those things. Let our prayers surround them and help them this day. We pray for India and other places ravaged by COVID, remembering the medical people working there and in our own healthcare system. Let your spirit nurture, guide, and support all who are working on the front lines in our hospitals and communities. For we pray for each other, for ourselves, and our world in a moment of silence. Loving and eternal God, by your grace and through your love, answer. For we pray everything in Jesus' name. Amen. As you head out into the day and the week ahead, open your eyes to see the wonder of God's creation around you. Open your hearts to feel God's love in your life, and open your hands and your mouths to speak and to share that love with others. And as you go, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, may the love of God, and may the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you this day and all of your days. Take care, and God bless.